So we're back in the bathroom again, okay? And we're looking to finish off the series on the bathroom zones that we've done, and you can find them right over here, okay? Now, the difference with this bathroom and one we haven't visited yet is we actually have a shower enclosure. So what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna look at the zones within the shower enclosure and the accessories we have in this bathroom for IP rating. So onto zone zero first. Now, where we had the bath, okay, zone zero was the space inside of the bath. And where we had a wet room, we looked at zone zero being the floor itself with a set diameter from the actual plug hole itself, okay? Now, with a shower tray, zone zero, believe it or not, is this area here, okay? So it's inside the shower tray itself. So all of this area, okay, up to this lip, where you're standing in the water, is zone zero. So zone one extends from zone zero, remembering the shower tray, zone zero being this point in the tray itself. So zone one will extend to 2.25 meters in height, okay? Or, as we've stated before in the other earlier videos, above a fixed outlet, okay? So if we go 2.25 meters, is actually the ceiling itself, okay? So the height of this ceiling is just below 2.25 meters, so zone one extends to there. We're now gonna look at zone two for the shower enclosure. Now, this actually works off of the edge of zone one, and it is again 600 millimeters from the edge of zone one is classed as zone two. So we know zone one being the edge of the shower tray. So if we go from here, we can see zone two extends to this point here. And the thing with the shower tray, because it goes around the room, we need to check 600 millimeters also from here. So we can tell that this is zone two as well. And if we flip the camera around, we can also see that 600 mil from this edge of zone, the zone one, will come just before the edge of this window. So this whole curvature here is actually classed as zone two. We're gonna look at the accessories that we've had to use to install inside of here. Now, we said that zone one actually extended to 2.25 meters, which was actually above the ceiling. So we're gonna use the ceiling, okay, as our point that zone one extends to. So if we come 600 mil from that, we actually find that our accessories fall within zone two of this bathroom. Now, what we're told is that it has to be a minimum of IPX4, okay, to be in zone two within a bathroom. Now, that means that the extractor fan here that we've got installed has to be a minimum of IPX4, which it is. And also the light fitting we have here is IP44, so therefore conforms to the IP ratings that we're allowed within that zone. Now, if that extractor fan, however, was not suitable, we might have to put an inline extractor in the loft. Now, that would mean there would just be like a vent here, and the actual fan, the electrical enclosure, would be in the loft space itself. So some people think that still needs to be IP rated. However, because it's not actually inside of the bathroom, but from our terms, if it is in the loft space itself and the electrical components are in that loft space, it is classed as outside of the zones. Therefore, general rules apply, no IP rating is needed. We've got three zones in here. Zone zero, which is inside the shower tray itself. Zone one, which extends from 2.25 meters or above the fixed outlet. And zone two, which follows a 600 mil distance from the edge of zone one around the curvature of this shower tray. With installed accessories, again, have to be IP rated, dependent on the zone they are in. So Eric, you felt like you've learned something in while shooting this video with me today?
Yeah, definitely.
So we talked about bathrooms, okay?
Yeah.
And it's not just bathrooms, we have bathrooms, saunas, swimming pools, etc. Mm-hmm. And what do we call them as a whole?
We call them special locations.
Special locations, good, okay. Mm-hmm. So this is classed as a special location.
Yeah.
And as always, Eric, we hope this video series
has been some help.
Has been some help.